In this video, I'm going to show you how to charge, say, a car battery, a bike battery, a boat battery that has very little charge or it's completely dead. Before you perform this method, it's good to check if the battery can actually be topped up. I have a video on this, I'll link it in the description below. Basically, the cells might have run dry and they just need topped up with distilled water. In a closed battery, a non-serviceable battery like this, we don't have that opportunity without either drilling in here or voiding the warranty or anything like that. So these are supposed to be closed cells and you're not supposed to top them up at all. So this is what usually happens. You hook up the charger to your battery, you put it on a 2-amp charge, and after 1 or 2 seconds you'll get an immediate fault and it won't charge. So I'm going to show you a trick on how to fix this. So a good working battery and, you know, fully charged, it's working correctly. After sitting for a couple of days, maybe even longer, it should read at 12.6 volts. In or around that mark. So you can see this is a perfectly good battery. And the battery we're trying to charge, which keeps faulting out with the charger, it reads only 5.54 volts. So this battery is pretty low, so less than 50%. So what we're going to do here, we're going to get a set of jumper cables and we're going to connect the batteries together. So positive to positive, negative to negative. Okay, so we just have the batteries connected together in series. I'm just going to probe the half-dead battery now on the terminal itself. You can see it's taken a very high average of the two batteries. And when we connect the charger to these in series, it's going to be enough voltage for the charger not to fault out and then start charging both batteries together. So what we do now, we just take our battery charger and connect this to the end. It doesn't really matter where we connect to because they're in series, so now we're just going to connect the charger there. So it's going to look like this, and then we're going to plug in the charger. So now with our battery charger, we can go to 2, 4, even 6 amps. It doesn't fault out because the voltage reading from both of them again reads around 12.5 volts, so that's perfectly acceptable and it won't fault out. So one thing you might want to know is my battery charger working? Now this same exact method you can use to test whether the alternator in a car is charging the battery while the engine's running. So while it's charging, we've got a 2-amp charge going into this. So we're just going to probe the battery terminals. And when we do that, it reads 13.12 volts. Now when this is not charging, it reads around, I think around 7 volts right now. So that confirms it's accepting a charge because the voltage reading is 6 volts higher. And when it's charging, it will read higher. When the charger is switched off, it will drop down to its actual current charge after a few minutes. So why does this fault feature exist? It's really just a safety feature because if the battery is compromised and it can't accept charge, then it just faults out to prevent overloading or, you know, like a mini sort of disaster. So I recommend doing this in an outside area, you know, just to be safe. I've never had any problems with this at all when doing it this method. One thing, just don't leave it charging, you know, for hours and hours unsupervised. Just check it every hour. You have a multimeter to check the voltage, etc. Once this battery has received enough charge, you can actually disconnect the jumper cables and continue to charge this battery by itself. This is just a booster to get it, you know, get it going really. And last thing I'll leave you with, always, always charge your battery with a low charge, so a 2-amp setting here. If you slow trickle charge it, that is the safest method, and also it'll make your battery last longer. If you start charging with a high sort of amperage here, they tend to charge fast, yes, but they don't really last as long. And again, since these are connected in series, I think 2 amps, you know, really low charge is a good setting to put this at. So once we've left this for say an hour or so, we can disconnect these jumper cables and this will begin to charge by itself. So I've left this on for about an hour and a half now. We're just going to put it back on the 2-amp charge and it's not faulting out. So we're good to go really. Some chargers, depending how much you pay, they'll actually stop charging when it's reached its capacity. And again, that'll be the full light here. So again, I'd prefer to monitor them. I don't really trust the checks in these cheap chargers, but it's just something to note. So I hope this tip helped you, and thanks for watching.